Thank you, county commissioners, for coming and sharing your thoughts on how the county is. The format will give the commissioners an opportunity to make a brief presentation about the issues or items that they feel should be brought to your attention. And then after each commissioner has spoken, we will begin posing the questions submitted by you, the audience. Please, again, remember to use the forms on your table and turn them into chamber staff. So again, thank you for participating today, and we'll begin with Commissioner President Randy Guy.
Am I on? Good, good. Thank you very much. Thank your chamber for hosting this, number one, and thank for all of you in the business community for coming out and participating. We've had a pretty interesting year. Number one, we have just coming out of this pandemic. It's been hard for everybody. It's been a big change. It's the worst thing in my life I've seen as far as trying to generate support for people and keeping our businesses open. But we did our best to keep our county open and business running. It was tough at times, but we're trying to keep everybody safe and hopefully healthy so we can continue our work. I know you down in the business world did the same thing, but it was pretty hard on our small businesses, and we did everything we could to put out monies to help you get through this from the various care grants and things we had, and I think we were somewhat successful in many of them. Unfortunately, we're restructuring, we're getting back to business, helped a few people, are finally getting people back to work, and this is a big thing. We are having problems just like everybody else as far as getting employees. Even the county's having a problem, and I talked to one of the administrators of the hospital. They're having a problem with nursing. Same problem with our veterans home in Charlotte Hall. They're at 63% capacity because they can't get people hired, mainly nursing and even other related things, even to take groundskeepers, the kitchen, things like that. They just can't get the people. And so it's tough, and we're probably going to be a few years before we probably get out of this. But I'm glad that we as a county government, I've led the county commissioner board now for 8 years as the president. I'm very proud of both of my boards that were in attendance. Several of us have been here now for 8 years. Just pointing out, sir. But, and Eric's done a great job, really has. And so we do our best to provide services for the people. That's our main job. Is, and I like to say that my main focus priority is education, public safety, and transportation. That's the key things that we need to provide. Schools are vital, not just, of course, our biggest budget, about 45% goes to our public schools from kindergarten all the way up through high school. And then we have CSM, what a great facility we have available for us there to put people through their first 2 years and move on to further education and academic or go through the trade center that we now have built out in Hughesville. And this is a very big part of our educational process here that many counties would love to have. And we have a tri-county effort here, and we put considerable money towards that. And I talked to just recently the budget that we put forward to put some extra scholarships this year, and I was told off a lot of people get over that hump and get their education completed. So I'm glad that happened. There's many things that I'd like to keep pushing for. One of the key things that I've always been pushing for, because unfortunately I'm the elder here, is realizing the last two 2010 and 2020 census that about 200% increase in senior population. And I'm all for doing everything we can to make sure that the seniors can stay home and be aging at home. There's a lot of programs out there. AARP has a designation to make our county, as we start working the process, senior friendly. And that's what I want to see, senior friendly for our county. I want to make sure that our seniors decide to stay here rather than run away somewhere. So whatever it takes to make our senior population stay in place, I'm up with it. I'm working hard for it. I also see recreation, especially with our county. We're surrounded by water. You know, we've got 550 miles plus of waterfront property. But unfortunately, most of it is privately owned. So whatever we can do to develop parks and everything, to let people recreate. You're working every day. You want some place to go that you can enjoy. And if I can offer some kind of waterfront park to go to, beaches, whatever, that's what I'm going to do. And I'm all for continuing to develop those areas right now. And everything else as far as we just purchased, as a matter of fact, down south here, Shannon Farm. we walked through woods and into the beach. We have a great, wonderful beach opportunity right there on the Chesapeake Bay, a beautiful piece of land. And that's our next project to get that done. I want to thank everybody who supports us. I want to thank everybody for attending today. And hopefully we'll get, next year will be a better year for all of us. And we'll continue to work hard to help any way we can. Thank you.
Thank you, Commissioner President Guy. Next, we will hear from the Commissioner of District 1, Commissioner Eric Colvin.
Thank you. So good afternoon, everyone. Thank you all for being here and taking time out of your busy days. Everybody's busy, I know that, and it's good to be able to have a chance to just enjoy lunch together and chat. State of the County presentation, the video, pretty good. Lisa did an amazing job with that and all the people who put the work into that. And I don't know if you all realize this, but this is our first time seeing it too. So we all get to see it for the first time together. And so it was very nicely done. One thing, I'm going to be brief because I know Commissioner Hewitt has a lot of really good notes and I don't want to steal any of his thunder. But one of the things highlighted in the State of the County video was the $2 million for broadband expansion. And one thing that I'm especially proud of is since that point in time, just a couple weeks ago, we allocated an additional $3.5 million to broadband expansion out of our American Rescue Grant funds. That is vitally important. Our neighboring counties are putting us to shame with their broadband expansion, and that is something that I'm going to continue to push for and this board is pushing for, and it's getting people connected. The internet is required this day and age, and it's a really good thing. So I'm just going to leave it at that, but thank you all for being here today.
Thank you, Commissioner Colvin. We will now hear from the commissioner representing Commissioner District 2, Mike Hewitt.
Good afternoon. Like many of you, I came from small business. I had the challenges of making the payroll every week, rising cost for, whether it be in cost to help, cost to insurance, just the overall cost of living in St. Mary's County, it's been high. Now, as a commissioner for the past 8 years, I've never forgot where I came from. I always knew that the money that I worked for was hard-earned money. I put in a lot of time. And you do the same thing. You show up every day. You give it your best shot. And you try to do the best you can. And thank God. And God bless you. Now, what I'll say about St. Mary's County is, our county is strong. I used to say in business, it's easy to run a business when there's a lot of business, when there's a lot of cash flow. It's hard to run one when there's none. The county right now is in an excellent position. We are very strong. We have the lowest unemployment rate in the state of Maryland, 4.2%. It's better than last year, which was the lowest at 4.5%. We are one of the fastest growing counties in the state, 8.9% with the last census growth. Those are good things. We also are able to borrow money. Our bond rating is staying at the highest we can stay. We can't get AAA because we're so dependent on NAS Patrick. It helps us with the average salaries, almost $90,000 a year in St. Mary's County. I mentioned that to people on the Eastern Shore, Somerset County, average salary, $24,000. We are very lucky to have these high salaries, but we have our challenges too. We had the highest assessment rate in the state last year. That's good for county government because our tax base increased. It increased to $14.1 billion. An increase of 4.1% over the year before. Now what that means is we're going to collect more money. What's also been very interesting is the last 4 years, or I should say five. In 2018, before the federal tax cut, which you all know had SALT, state limit, local tax deductions, a cap put on those, our revenues and income tax were $90 million. Last year, they were $132 million. 4 years later, we raised $42 million. That's quite an increase. Now, what we have to keep in mind is What we found was, is 2% of the people in St. Mary's County pay 22% of those income taxes. We have a lot of wealthy people. That's a good thing. This is a good place to start a business. But we have our challenges, and that's trying to find out how do we keep our taxes low. This commissioner board's been lucky enough to reduce income tax last 2 years. We're still going to have revenue growth over expenses this year to the tune of $12 to $15 million. But we need to take a hard look at how we attract and retain talent. Like all of you, we're paying more to bring people here, to keep them here. We need to fill our vacancies, just like you do. So what we need to do is we need to find a way to control the cost on people who aren't fixed income, our seniors, our poor, our working poor. And it's election year. Who knows what the next board will look like? We'll have two new commissioners. The other three have opponents. So we'll see what the next board look like. But the challenges will be how we take the impacts off the people who are hurt the worst. And that'll be a challenge for all of us. But I'll say this, it's a good time to be in St. Mary's County. If you're not busy, it's because you don't want to be, or it's because maybe you're not doing the best work that's out there. I hear it from all the traders. Everybody's busy. These are good times, should be good times for you. Thank you.
Thank you, Commissioner Hewitt. Unfortunately, the commissioner representing District 3, John O'Connor, could not be in attendance today. So we will now move on to hear from Commissioner for District 4, Commissioner Todd Morgan. But before we begin, I want to remind everyone to fill out the green form if you have a question, because after Commissioner Morgan speaks, we will be asking the commissioners your questions. So without further ado, Commissioner Morgan.
Thank you, and thank you to the Chamber for hosting us today. I'm going to start off a little different, because I think as many of you know, this is my last State of the County address. And I think we'll go back on a group called the Grateful Dead. And if you remember Grateful Dead, they said, lately occurs to me what a long, strange trip it's been. So when they were shuffling off to Buffalo, I shuffled into St. Mary's County, and I said, hey, go Bills. Now, I look back at my first term, and what was the big thing the voters wanted the first term? They wanted a new movie theater, they wanted Buffalo Wild Wings. So with a lot of perseverance and work, we were able to open the movie theater up at the Lexington Exchange, and Buffalo Wild Wings sort of just came by itself. Then if you remember, there was a fire at Spring Ridge Middle School, and that decimated the school down there, but fortunately, the board that had preceded me left us enough money, and we were able to fix the school without having to wait for the state to give us money. And oh, by the way, that last accomplishment there was the building of the Patuxent River Naval Air Station just outside Gate 3. So let's try to look back on maybe these 12 years. I guess that's a little bit different approach. So over the last 12 years, I can say we've successfully supported our Board of Education, and I think except for 1 year, we've always overfunded our maintenance of effort agreement with them, making sure the teachers are taken care of, the kids are being taken care of, and right now we're still on tap to meet the Kerwin plan obligations based upon what happens in the future. We built a new school out there in Leonardtown, kept the water Francis Duke. We've put millions and millions of dollars in infrastructure upgrades, so our schools are there, and we've added three turf fields to the high school so the kids can compete with their peer groups across the state. In higher education, we committed the first $1 million to the University of Maryland Smart Building out on the Airport Road. We're actually ahead of the state to show the commitment of the commissioners to that facility. In law enforcement, we've continued to expand our jail, adult detention center, I guess you call it. We've invested heavily in community policing. We made wages for the law enforcement and corrections officers competitive with their peers across the board. And we also modified the retirement system to keep our law enforcement office here in St. Mary's and not go into Charles or Calvert County. We focused on Lexington Park. And over that time, we have invested more than $70 million in Lexington Park alone in infrastructure improvements. It represents the single largest investment the county has made over these years. Other areas, quite frankly, have not received as much money, but this is where one of our growth centers in, and probably one of the newest economic development areas we can concentrate on. The recs and parks investments have been significant. It was pointed out in the video. We've upgraded almost all the facilities. We've upgraded and expanded the three-notch bike trail, built a BMX track, installed lightings in many of the parks. We developed the Lexington Park Passive Park. We've added turf fields to our regional parks. We've expanded waterfront access to a lot of locations, expanded the properties at Chana Farms and others. Economic development, they've included a lot of money going into the regional airport, our Airport Innovation District, in concert working with the University of Maryland. We spun up the tourism department as a separate entity. We focus many of our American relief dollars to hard-hit small businesses. We have a new farmer's market called the Barnes at Newmarket going in, and we will be building the Regional Agricultural Center somewhere in the north end of the county, and we also receive sustainable economic development grants for Lexington Park. Public Works, I can't tell you the number of great things that they have accomplished over the years that you just don't see. The road improvement projects, the highway overlay projects, the road repair projects, clearing out for the snowplows, etc. We've added a new animal shelter. We built more sidewalks to make it easier and accessible for Lexington Park people to be able to get around. We've endured through storms, droughts, hurricanes, floods, and always, but that department has always been there for our citizens. Emergency services, they were hard. Did you want to hear me anymore? Dead. We're all back. Okay. They've hired EMT personnel to supplement our emergency service people. We've added ambulances, emergency response vehicles, and we continue to support the requests of our fire and rescue squads. The technology was brought up. We have developed state-of-the-art communication systems. I don't think if anybody remembers years ago, we went through the radio replacement project for the fire and the police departments. So how much that has improved their ability. As Commissioner Coleman brought up, how much money we've invested in broadband. And I think one of these days, Commissioner Coleman and I will get broadband. We just don't know what it's going to be. So please don't think commissioners get preference in any of these deals, okay? Land use, they've streamlined processes to keep up with the problems that the state and federal government keep imposing on us. On human services, we built a new library in the Garvey Senior Center in Leonardtown, expanded our caring networks to provide meals and transportation services for those in need of them, expanded offerings at the senior centers, especially now that we're getting into a new season. We're opening up the senior centers that we later tonight to help our seniors. We work with the health department as they struggle through COVID and utilized federal resources for additional health and mental care projects. So I'm sure I've left a few things out. And as I've rambled on about these projects don't come cheap. But we've been very fortunate, as Commissioner Hewitt pointed out, that we've been able to do this expansion with interest rates being probably just about zero. And we've held the line on taxes. And as I look at you today, when I came in, we were in a strong financial position. And when I leave, we're also in a strong financial position. So as I conclude, I want to thank a few people. First of all, I want to thank the county employees and the staffs. I don't think you realize, after working with them for 12 years, the backbone that they have become to make this place better, and also for the three boards I've worked with. I will say, as you leave, or as I leave, term limits are good. And I very much enjoyed being your commissioner for the last 12 years. And I want to thank everyone here for their support over the years. As I begin a new chapter in my life and turn the page, we'll see where it ends up. But for that, I want to say thank you to everyone.
Thank you, Commissioner Morgan. We will now begin with questions, and there is still time to submit your question. The first question is directed towards Commissioner President Guy. What areas are served in each district, and who represents each district? So what town, cities are served by each district, and who is the representative for each district?
We've already made that announcement. You want to know what town you're used to?
Yes.
Well, Commissioner Morgan's got Lexington Park, Valley League, Ridge.
Mr. Hughes got the Leonard Town, Hollywood, that area right there.
The mechanics.
And myself, I'm sort of at large. I represent everybody. Actually, we all, I would like to say that we as commissioners, there's only five. It's not like the delegates up in Napa, we have hundreds that show up in our meetings. You listen, Denton? By now? Okay, back on again. There's five commissioners. When we, after the election, I don't care who you are, once you come into the dais and sit down, we make decisions that respect the entire county, not just one particular district or town. We are supporting the entire county. Now, we depend on our staff to provide us with information on where our needs, or whatever needs might be, are generally needed in towns or cities or whatever. We really don't have, even though he represents the first district, I do expect Eric, for example, to take the lead on first district items. But we make a decision of five of us together, and that's how we work together.
Thank you. This question is for Commissioner Morgan. Why can't the commissioners pressure the state to finally finish the Leonardtown Route 5 widening project? How many more years will go by on this short extension? Citizens are suffering, and it's already been over 3 years.
You're right, it's been over 3 years. And I think that, you know, this becomes a state question that the delegation has to push a little bit harder on. If I'm fortunate enough to get to Annapolis, we keep pushing for that and other road improvements, particularly looking down Route 5 towards past Buzzies to finish that extension down there. But those are state projects, and the commissioners can say all they want, but eventually at the end of the day, it really becomes a delegation that's got to figure that one out. It's going to be done this fall? Route 5? Well, they say Route 5 is going to be done this fall. Like I said, it's been 3 years that we've waited. And same thing with Route 5 going down south towards Camp Maria. Yeah.
Thank you. The next question is for both Commissioner Colvin and Commissioner Hewitt. And we'll start with Commissioner Colvin. Can you update us about the status of the YMCA projects in Lexington Park?
Yes, it's on track. Right now, it has been approved by the commissioners. It is in the budget. It is going through. The Y is doing their process, and I believe that once the initial engineering design work is done, they'll be coming back to us, but it is on process and on track.
Commissioner Hewitt?
Yes, the YMCA is on track, but the next big step is going to be the elections. Because once the elections are over, there'll be at least two new commissioners, and there could be more. So what has to happen is needs to be a reconfirmation that we are going to build a YMCA. And that'll happen in December. It'll be one of the first things the new board does after the elections. We get the people who are elected get sworn in on the first Monday in December, and then on that first Tuesday we have our first meeting, and we will talk about priorities, or the talk will be about priorities. Now, what's going on with the YMCA? Right now, we're trying to make sure we have the property. Everybody, I think, knows it's designated to go next door to the Great Mills High School. The county has 19 acres there. Now, we have an existing pool, which they will take over. That's a good thing for the county, because that pool's expensive, and the YMCA will endure all those costs. It's a good example of a public-private partnership. What I've said about the YMCA, they've been in business 168 years. They're the McDonald's of Wrexham Market. They know how to do YMCAs. What they will bring to the county will be the benefits of a YMCA, and it'll be beneficial to everybody because it'll be cheaper. They have a cost set up that they give scholarships, so the lower income, the lower you pay. It'll be a good job. But right now, we're in the A&E phase, and that's architectural and engineering. We have to make sure we can build this thing for $21 million or less. If it goes over, then the commissioner board will make a decision as to what happens going forth for the total budget.
Thank you. And we'll stick with Commissioner Hewitt. What ideas do the commissioners have to assist the Sheriff's Department with the increase in violent crime in St. Mary's County?
Great question. Lord knows Violent crime in St. Mary's County has been a challenge. It's getting worse and worse each year. But we do support our sheriff's department. We've been giving them raises. We've been giving them materials and equipment to fight this. We've even actually let them take emergency funding to rent adjacent townhomes or whatever structures they need so they can observe the groups that are causing most of these issues. Let's understand that what we have, and it's in the Lexington Park here at Padama, and we cannot give up on Lexington Park. We've got to keep at it. But we have groups that are, they're young. They're young people, predominantly male, 15, 16, 17, 18 years old, and they have guns. It's a terrible situation. Now, our police officers are in a tough spot. But what we need is we need our communities to come out. I say this, the people who live in these areas know who the people are. We need everybody's help. They need everybody's help. Because it just can't be law enforcement picking them up. Now, the other part gets to be, and I hear this a lot, we need prosecutors and we need judges that hold people accountable and make sure that they don't get released back into the street in a fast manner, which they feel like there was no repercussions to it. But it's a very challenging problem. And what I would say to you is we're going to try and, I hate to use the term throw more money, but give more resources. Because with more resources, our sheriff's department can do more.
Thank you. The next question is for Commissioner Morgan. As we emerge from the pandemic and some federal government funding ceases, what are priorities and plans for state and county government?
What are the priorities for state and local government?
Yes.
I think they go back to the initial three that the county commissioners have focused on for some time, which is going on the infrastructure side, public safety side, transportation, education.
And does anyone else, any of the other commissioners have anything to add? So this is the last question. If you have any more questions, feel free to hand them off to Christine, who's raising her hand in the back. But this one is for Commissioner President Guy. Will the county ever give a better discount or no property tax for seniors and or disabled veterans, both of which are leaving the county, even to neighboring counties? The current tax relief is only at $250,000 to the questionnaire's knowledge. So is there anything, any tax discount or no property tax for seniors? Disabled veterans.
If I'm not mistaken, we already have, if you look at the back of your tax bill, you get it. There's already three different tax reliefs for seniors. Also, as far as disabled American veterans, if you are 100% disabled, you're tax free. So you have to look at your billing and question our treasurer on this, but there are limits. You can only do so much with reducing taxes on seniors. But one of the things I'd like to see more of, and I'm an advocate, and I can tell you, we go to Annapolis every winter in general session. I've stood up the lone person in 24 jurisdictions to exempt all retirement from taxation. And I'm going to stand up constantly, not just for military retirement, but for all retirement. And of course, I can't get the other candidates to come around the same way, but to get that reduced deduction like for your pay, it's got to come from the state level. Locally, there's limits you put on because most of it has an income level. For example, I'm just going to put a figure, I'm not sure what it is, but maybe $80,000 or more, you're not going to get a big exemption from your property tax. Or say you have a home that's valued at $600,000-$800,000. Obviously, you have a good income to start with to get it there, and unless you meet the parameters of lower income, say less than $80,000, you have restricted income, then of course you can get a reduction. I'd like to see more tax relief for veterans, especially those that are 50% disabled or more. Those are being worked.
but at this time right now, I don't know that for sure from veterans with 100% disability, you get a big exemption on the property tax. But I continue to work for more because I'm a veteran myself. And but I want to see retirement pay, especially for all of us that are retiring, to keep you here in this county is to try to do our best to reduce the income tax. And that's a big relief right there. Because that's what many states do. But I'll tell you one thing, you got to look twice when you decide to run down to Florida, Texas, wherever. Look at all the other taxes they impose on you before you run down. Because I just had a son who went down to North Carolina. And yeah, the real estate tax seems to be small, but they got a big personal property tax down there. But him and his wife went in and put their cars, they get a tag on it, they had to pay $1,600 total for two cars. And that's a yearly fee they have to pay. So we observed of all the taxes that they have in that state. And I went to the store to go shopping at a grocery store. I got my receipt. I had to spend about $120. There was three different taxes, just in North Carolina, on that grocery bill. So you've got to be careful when you go to these other states. Know what you're going before you get there. Because a lot of people get back. I've noticed in North Carolina, Wilmington area, there's a lot of people that are there that went to Florida, decided to come to Carolina. They still want to get to Maryland, but they stay in North Carolina now. They call them halfbacks. Because you found out in Florida, when it's been your body was. So believe me, St. Mary's County, I know the taxes seem to be high, but believe me, they're not compared to many other states and even other counties. We have a good rate, and we will look as a board, and we're getting this good funding money right now. If we can reduce any taxes, we will do that. I'm all for reducing taxes as much as we can.
Thank you. Thank you. So that was the last question. I want to thank the county commissioners today for their participation. Thank you for giving your ideas and thoughts about how the county is doing and where you see the county going in the future. I would also like to thank our sponsors, PNC Bank, SMECO, and the St. Mary's County Department of Economic Development, as well as Cedar Point Federal Credit Union, College of Southern Maryland, and the Community Bank of the Chesapeake. And of course, this program would not be a success without all of our attendees. So thank you for attending and enjoy the rest of your day.